Hello everyone, I am Pradeep B and I am here to represent my group for the final year presentation. The title of our project is actually Electrical Impedance Tomography. So, let me give you a brief introduction about the Electrical Impedance Tomography, shortly called as EIT. So, EIT is a new imaging technique which is an alternative for CT and MRI scans. So, CT and MRI scans usually use X-rays or radio waves, and also they are some kind of invasive things. So our technique is actually non-invasive. That means we do not penetrate into the body. We just take the electrodes, place it on the body, and then we take the readings. So let me tell you how the functioning of EIT takes place. So basically, we actually stick about 16 electrodes on the surface of the chest. So in order to take the readings. So why go for 16 electrodes? 16 electrodes because it is a mesh pattern. So we can actually start from 8 electrodes, 16, 32 in that combination, because we need radially opposite electrodes in order to take the readings. And why only go for lung? Because the resistivity of the lung area or the thorax is actually higher compared to other organs inside the body. So we can easily measure the conductivity values or as the resistivity values from the lungs. Now let us discuss about the parts of this electrical impedance tomography system. So basically we have three parts majorly. One is the electrodes, the second is the hardware system, and the third is the software system. So these electrodes, that are 16 electrodes, we are actually sticking these electrodes on the surface of the chest of the person under scan. So these electrodes will actually send the signals to the hardware system, and it will be sending the data to the software system. So the method of taking the readings is as follows. So first we will be actually sending the current, that is a very low value of current of 1 milliamps, to two electrodes. Let us name the electrodes as number 1 and 2. So we will be sending the currents between the electrodes 1 and 2, and then we will be measuring the voltage values from the remaining rest of electrodes, like 13 electrodes. So here we will be sending the current from between the electrodes number 1 and 2, and the voltage will be measured from the remaining electrodes. So in the same way, this will be actually one iteration. In the same way, electrodes will be passed to the second and third electrode, and the voltage value will be measured from the remaining electrodes. Therefore, we will be having 13 voltage values in the entire iteration. So this is how the current will be injected. This is the injection pattern. So this is about the injection pattern and how the data is being collected. Now this data is actually being collected and controlled with the help of the hardware system as shown below. So the hardware system, the main major components in the hardware system are actually Arduino board, that is Arduino Mega 2560, and the three muxes that are being used. So the muxes are actually used to collect the data and also to send the signals. So for example, one mux will be used to send the signal, whereas the other two muxes will be used to take the signals, that is take the voltage values from the electrodes. And the Arduino is actually programmed to control the entire operation of collecting the data as well as sending the electrical pulses. And next, the software part is actually used to reconstruct the data as well as control the Arduino board. For that, we are using Arduino IDE as a controlling program, and MATLAB will be used to reconstruct the image from the data obtained from the Arduino setup. Now, let us see the functioning or the operation of the entire system. First, we will be dumping the program, that is the Arduino program, into the Arduino board using the Arduino IDE software. So now, I'll actually dump the program now. This will take a few seconds of time in order to dump the program. As you can see, the Arduino, it is being programmed now, and as you can see the screen now, the program has been dumped. So immediately after dumping the program, the process of data collection will start. So this will be actually indicated by the lighting up of two green LEDs, that is in the LED indication system as shown in the hardware setup. These are the two LEDs that you can, as you can see there. This indicates that the data collection has been started from the Arduino board. So that means the current is being transferred between the first two electrodes and the voltage is being taken. So this process continues for a few more minutes until the entire iteration completes. Okay, at the end of the complete iteration, the Arduino will indicate the red LED indicating that the data has been completely collected and the operation has been stopped. So as you can see there, the Arduino is showing the red LED indication. So this means that the entire data has been collected and it is transferred to the system with the help of a TTL to serial converter, as you can see here, the USB to TTL converter. So through this, we are sending the data to the system.
Now the data has been collected and it can be seen in the MATLAB software. So I'll open the MATLAB now. Here I've previously given the directory or the path to store the data, and it is stored as EIT data 01. I'll open the matrix now. It is actually stored in the form of a CSV file. So here I'm loading the data. Now it's loaded. You can see here it is shown as here. So zoom in a bit. So these are the values. These are the voltage values corresponding to the readings taken from the electrodes. So this is the data that we have collected till now.
Go.
Now this data has to be processed in order to give it to the image reconstruction software. That is, here we are using the software called as EIDORS or EDORS. So for that we need to process this data, and that processing is actually done using a MATLAB program. Now I'll actually start the MATLAB program here. First we look. Now before running the main program, we need to set up the MATLAB software for using the EDORS software. For that we need to run a startup file in the EDORS software. So let us do the first thing. Here, as you can see, that is the startup file. Double click on it. Now we have to run this startup file so that the EDORS software can easily link with the MATLAB program that we have written. So as you can see in the command window, the instructions have been taken out, and as you can see it has been executed. Now the EDORS is successfully linked with the MATLAB, and now we can actually run our program, that is the main program, which actually processes the data and provides the data to the EDORS software and uses the FEM model in order to reconstruct the image. Now let us open our main program. So this is the main program. So here, as you can see there, now first we are actually creating a model, EDORS object model, and then the data what we have collected till now, it is actually passed on to the variable called data. Now let me run this program now. As you can see in the command window, first it shows the directory, that means where the data is stored. After that, as you can see, it gives an instruction or a final output as run the final image.m. So this is actually a function that actually works with EDORS software. So now we'll run that function or that file. Here it is a file. Now as you can see, this is the final image.m file. Here it contains all the instructions in order to obtain the final image output. As you can see here, the base name is given as data, that is the variable data what we have seen earlier. Now let me run this now. So as you can see in the command window, the process actually starts now. And the one more thing is that all the details or all the the color or the pixel edge, everything is actually decided by the EDORS software to the default values. As you can see there, the matrix name is given as subject 1, and the EDORS software will actually set the colors to the default value. And now we will be able to see the final output, as you can see in the pop-up screen. So this is the final image what we get from the data that we have collected from the person on whom we have stick the electrodes. So as you can see, this is the lung image. So in conclusion, what we have done till now is just taking the values of impedance from the subject or the person, and we have taken the data, processed it, and we have reconstructed the image using FEM model. So this is the final output of our project. Thank you.